Hey, what's up everybody and welcome back to News Dose, and thanks to some new information, it now appears another interesting announcement will be made at the upcoming Xbox showcase that I think a lot of fans are going to be quite happy about. This has quickly become a fan favorite among Xbox fans, so this showcase, it is starting to shape up if anything else. It's almost hard to believe, but we are only 9 days away from that event, so we'll talk about that a little later on today, and then also some surprising Nintendo announcements. They might not have a June showcase per se, but hey, they're doing their own little thing over on Twitter, which includes apparently a few surprise announcements that fans weren't expecting. As usual though, before we get started, do hit those buttons below, like, subscribe, and do ring that bell for more content just like this. But with that said, let's just go and jump right into things. Starting off with a brand new headset that was just announced, and this one's quite unique in the sense that it's a mixed reality headset. This is the Meta Quest 3, which is being advertised as a combination of a virtual reality headset and then also an augmented reality headset. Now, that is quite an interesting combination on paper, as augmented reality offers some benefits that VR doesn't. I mean, on one side you have VR, which is more about transporting you into an entirely new world to just completely immerse yourself into the environment, whereas augmented reality, that's more about incorporating virtual elements into the real world around you. So in a way, they are complete opposites with how they handle things, but with this combination here, AR has a chance to kind of come over to a popular headset, and I would say currently, AR is a little underutilized. I mean, years and years ago, if you remember right, there was that HoloLens Minecraft concept that they showed on stage. It was quite impressive for the time, but the HoloLens, it just never really took off for the general public. It was far, far too expensive, but that is the cool thing about the Meta Quest headsets. I mean, from a technical standpoint, these aren't necessarily the best headsets on the market, but what they've done is they've done such a good job over the years at keeping the price down. These are some of the most affordable headsets on the market. They're also a standalone device, so you don't need a PC, you don't need a PlayStation 5, and in this case, the Meta Quest 3 will debut at $500 for the 128GB option. Now, they did note that there will be other options if you want more storage, but for a VR headset, or in this case, a mixed reality headset, that's not a bad price. With that in mind, though, they are also lowering the price for the Quest 2. Starting June 4th, it will go for $299. Now, I actually do own the Quest 2 among a few other VR headsets, and I would recommend this device if you're interested in virtual reality. It might not necessarily be as powerful, again, as something like the PlayStation VR 2 or other PC VR headsets out there, but it does offer a great library of 500-plus games at a great price, which is always one of the sticking points for newcomers to virtual reality. This is not a cheap technology to get into. Oh, and by the way, since we're talking about games, they did also confirm that the Meta Quest 3 will be fully backwards compatible on top of all of its new games, including Assassin's Creed Nexus. They announced Bulletstorm, interestingly enough. That's pretty cool. And the one that I think is the most exciting, Asgard's Wrath 2. I think to this day, the first Asgard's Wrath still remains one of the best VR titles available, as it's a legitimate AAA RPG. The only thing is, though, we still don't have a release date for any of this yet. All that they're currently saying is that the Meta Quest 3 will launch this fall, and they have another showcase planned for September 27th, so go ahead and mark your calendars for that. Now, speaking of showcases, though, the next week or so is going to be a lot of fun. Of course, a few big games are releasing. Hey, hope you're all having fun out there with Street Fighter 6 right now. But also on June 8th, we have the Summer Game Fest to look forward to. Then on June 11th, there's the Xbox and Starfield showcases. And then one day later, on June 12th, there's also the Ubisoft Forward live stream. Well, Ubisoft just dropped a new trailer that gives us a glimpse as to what to expect there. This includes Avatar Frontiers of Pandora. We really haven't seen much of this game so far. We still do need to see some legitimate gameplay, not just some CGI trailers. So hopefully this will be the place where we finally see some gameplay. Then also Assassin's Creed Mirage will get another update here. I mean, we just saw this at the PlayStation Showcase. It honestly looks pretty good, as it's taking players back to the roots of the Assassin's Creed franchise. I know a lot of fans have been requesting a return to that type of gameplay. And I mean, so far, It looks promising, but we will get yet another look on June 12th. Then also they're going to be showing something on the Crew Motorfest. I'm not really a big Crew fan myself, but if you do like this series, that's something to note here as well. And then lastly, Assassin's Creed Nexus will be there. This was actually confirmed at the MetaQuest 3 showcase that we just talked about a moment ago. We will get a look into that game on June 12th as well. Those right now, though, are your four confirmations, but they are also, interestingly enough, teasing an unannounced game as well. So we'll see about all of that here soon enough. But hey, I'd say that that's actually a pretty decent lineup of games to look forward to. I mean, I'm still kind of hoping for a Splinter Cell update. That's the one that I would most like to see. But, with them not mentioning anything here, it's probably unlikely. At the very least, though, we can now set our expectations appropriately. Now, as for the Xbox showcase, though, hype is starting to build online. There's been a lot of talk about Fable over the last week, to the point that Aaron Greenberg posted a picture on his Instagram, and so fans once again took this picture as a Fable tease. You can see in the background here, there's some text that says Able. So maybe that's a sly tease, or at least that's what fans are currently speculating on right now, but no, it's actually not. If you've seen this past round online, you can just go ahead and disregard it, because Aaron Greenberg did respond to Colt Eastwood and set the record straight. Colt responded to the speculation online by saying, no, that's a cafeteria restaurant in the Microsoft office. And then Aaron, he responded saying, correct, and I've not teased anything. Prefer for our fans to be surprised when they watch live. But it does feel like right now, if I sneeze, someone will say X game is confirmed. Love you all in a passion. Keep it coming, as we are about a week away. Hashtag hold the line. So there you go. No Fable tease here. We can all just kind of move on. Now, at the same time, though, this doesn't necessarily mean that there won't be a Fable announcement at the Xbox showcase, but this in itself was not a tease. And this is the first time this week that somebody from Xbox came out to correct some of the speculation going around. Now, again, does that mean that the other tease earlier this week wasn't Fable related? I guess we'll see, but I'll just kind of continue to say, temper your expectations. If it's there, that's amazing. It does look like a Fable tease, but at the same time, don't put all of your stock into a single game announcement. Actually, however, there is something very interesting happening with another Xbox game, being Hi-Fi Rush. This game has quickly become a fan favorite among Xbox fans, and I'd say for good reason. It honestly might be the best new IP this year so far. It really is a fantastic game if you haven't already played it. It's on Xbox Game Pass, it's also on Steam, and it is perfectly playable on a Steam Deck as well if you do own that device. Definitely go check this game out if you haven't already, but for those that have, go ahead and perk your ears up here, because some new achievements have been spotted online. Now, the reason that this is noteworthy is because new achievements could possibly signify new DLC. Again, keep in mind that this isn't 100% guaranteed or anything like that, but you can look on the Steam database where it has 10 new achievements. So if there is some type of new DLC incoming, well, with the timing of all of this, maybe there could be an announcement at the upcoming Xbox showcase. I think if there is some type of DLC, it would make a lot of sense to announce it there. Maybe we could get even another stealth launch. I mean, DLC in itself, I think, makes a lot of sense for this game. I mean, both Xbox and PC fans seem to absolutely adore Hi-Fi Rush. If you go look over on Steam, it still has overwhelmingly positive reviews. It has an 88 Metacritic score. And then just here recently, Xbox said this: Hi-Fi Rush was a breakout hit for us and our players in all key measurements and expectations. We couldn't be happier with what the team at Tango Gameworks delivered with this surprise release. So that all kind of spells, hey, let's do something else with this game to really capitalize on its success. Truthfully, I'd like to see this become a full-fledged franchise for them in the future, but this soon after release, hey, a simple DLC, that would be more than good enough. Let me know what you all think about this, though. Would you be excited about some Hi-Fi Rush DLC? And also, would you like to see a sequel in the future? Now, with us talking about all these different showcases, I mean, we talked about the MetaQuest showcase, we talked about Ubisoft, and then also Xbox. But, Nintendo, they did something very surprising yesterday. I mean, no, they don't have a June showcase per se or anything like that, but that, however, didn't stop them from announcing some new stuff over on their Twitter account, and this includes a new line of controllers and then also a brand new first-party game. Maybe not what you would necessarily expect. We'll get back to that here in just a moment. But first here, let's go and take a look at these new Joy-Con controllers. This is their new pastel color lineup, which will be launching on June 30th. There's two different options here, the yellow and pink combination, and then also the purple and green combo. Now, as with all their first-party Joy-Cons, these are set for $80, but these things are already selling out. As of this recording, over on the official Nintendo website, both options are currently sold out. So yeah, just as a little heads up here, if you do like these collars and if you want some, I'd recommend following somebody like Wario64 over on Twitter. If any other retailer gets these things in stock, which I suspect that they will, I'm sure Wario will be one of the first to notify fans. Other than that though, I just gotta keep an eye on the Nintendo store and hey, hopefully these things will come back in stock. Nintendo though, they weren't quite done there, as yes, they did also have a stealth first-party announcement that they just kind of dropped over on Twitter. I know there's been those constant questions. Now that Zelda Tears of the Kingdom is out, what's next for the Switch? I mean, really, if you think about it, the only game that we 100% know is currently coming, at least in 2023, is Pikmin 4. Now, maybe Metroid Prime 4 comes at a later date, though I think that that might actually get pushed over to the Switch successor. We'll see about all that. But yesterday, they did confirm another first-party title because we also now officially know about Everybody Switch 1-2. So, there you go. This game is actually real. Switch 1-2 is, in fact, getting a sequel as previously rumored. Now, there were some reports last year that this game's been done for a while when Nintendo just didn't know what to do with it. They lacked confidence in it after some negative playtest feedback. But here we are a year later, and it's now primed to release, actually, later this month. It is officially set to launch alongside those pastel Joy-Cons that we just talked about a moment ago on June 30th, and so far, we haven't even gotten a trailer for this game, just a simple key art and its price tag, which is $30 for both physical and digital. Now, because they didn't drop a trailer though, we'll just go ahead and use the first game's trailer to kind of give you an idea as to what to expect with its sequel. It was a launch title for the Switch back in 2017. It plays into the whole Joy-Con gimmick and its unique features. It's a rather weird trailer with all of its different mini games, but more or less, it's a party game. The sequel here though, interestingly enough, is also attempting to incorporate smart devices in some shape or form. Again, right now we don't have a trailer, but the description does confirm this, and you can even see in the key art here, a bunch of people are holding up their smartphones. So yeah, just go and move on over Tears of the Kingdom because a new beast is coming to town on June 30th. Let's go and take a look at the poll of the day that we're asked you all, with Capcom asking fans, which Resident Evil game would you most like to see them remake next? And as you can see here, the majority of you voted for Code Veronica. Then 25% of you all voted for Resident Evil 1. Closer behind that, you have Dino Crisis at 22%. And then here at the bottom, you have Resident Evil 5 with 16%. Now, I do find that to be a little interesting because it does show you the reluctance towards Resident Evil 5 being the next remake. Sure, it's the next game in a series after Resident Evil 4, but it seems like a lot of you would prefer other entries over Resident Evil 5. Now, I am a little surprised, though, to see Code Veronica take that number one spot here, but at the same time, I do like the idea because, you know, it is a lesser-known entry. Based on my research, it's not even a top 10 best-selling Resident Evil title, so this would almost feel like a brand new game for a lot of fans out there. So I do like that theory to bring this one back, but I think for me, I'm gonna go ahead and go with you Dino Crisis fans out there. I mean, as much as I love the Resident Evil series, and I hope we continue to see more and more of these games, I'd also like to see something new here. Why not just go ahead and foster another franchise and let that grow alongside Resident Evil? Now, I keep saying just how good of a job Capcom has done here in recent years, but let's kind of build on that success with even more pillar franchises. I mean, can you imagine having Resident Evil, Monster Hunter, Dragon's Dogma, and also Dino Crisis? That to me just sounds like an absolutely killer lineup. And if Dragon's Dogma and Dino Crisis has success, well, then they just kind of set up themselves for the next decade with even more variety at their fingertips. Truth be told though, I mean, I'd really be happy if any of these games gets remade. Anyways though, that's it for this episode. But if you liked the video, don't forget to bell notification and subscribe button for more content just like this. Also, if you'd like to support the channel through Patreon, thank you for making this content possible. Peace out.